same one Adam had for years?
No.
Just a new one.
No.
I think I've ever seen one that had just like years
ago. All right. Watching. Guys, speak up.
Shut up!
We're recording now.
Sorry. Being watched by a mechanical device.
Dana, Dana's an A, right? Dana.
Dana.
Got you.
And we got Rusty the Roadie.
Rusty the Roadie.
Iggy Pop. We have Iggy Pop over here at Flavor Dot.
We got Alex over here. And I forgot your name.
Iggy Pop.
Iggy Pop.
Iggy Pop.
Bruce Dickinson.
Bruce Dickinson. And then we have
Tom.
Of course.
Tom Leprechaun.
Okay, since you asked the question, who the fuck is Martha Spiderhead?
Back over to Blaine.
No, that's Tom's. Tom answers that one.
I don't answer that one very good. It's a.
He's a 10-point.
Does this go up a little bit? Okay. It was
I got you covered.
Okay. It's a fictitious one that Blaine came up with. He says she's real, but I have yet to.
She lives in Seattle.
Yeah. She she's a figment of Blaine's imagination. She's a knife wielding maniac. She barbecues guys instead of guys barbecuing girls.
All right.
It's then she has big tits, so she's not all that great.
She's got what?
Her tits are big, so.
So people
like to get extra barbecue guys, but she has big tits.
Yeah, so that's
massive.
Supposedly,
that's girls like her for that, and guys.
That's bad.
Supposedly, that's points against us.
That makes us all clean for that. Explicitly incorrect. I am now politically incorrect.
That's right. Just skin it. We're no longer politically correct.
Okay, so all right, who was the founder of this band?
Dana and Tom. Tom and Dana.
Tom.
That's Dana.
For how long, guys?
We've been together since 1981.
May of.
So it's like a 6-year anniversary.
Damn. Woo! Here we are in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. Yes, at our 6-year anniversary. Yeah, it has been.
Hanging out with the West Village
and
crew.
It's been really fun every 6 years. In fact, we've known her for probably 5 of the 6 years. That's Angie.
Probably six of the six years.
Yeah. Our first demo tape, she probably produced the thing. Well, I know. No. Yeah, well, 6 whopping years. Long time.
Angie created us in her kitchen.
That's right. popped out of the Toastmatic oven.
A little strong. House of Toast?
He's finished talking now, but look at the picture. I'm pretending like you want to talk, guys.
I'll talk to you. You move your lips. Watch.
I'm like a tiny
boogie.
You know, ready?
So do that. Tom will talk and I'll move my lips.
Okay, yeah,
do it.
Go ahead and answer a question, then I'll move it. He'll move
all
his
right.
Answer
wait,
question.
No, all right, all right.
Here we go.
Okay.
Right.
Okay, ask him the question. I'll move my lips. Okay.
All right, has there been any lineup changes to the band?
Of course. No, I don't think there's been any lineup changes since about 9 months ago. We got Alex in the band about 9 months ago, and Blaine about 2.5
3 years ago.
3 years ago. Now.
What's the anniversary on that?
All right, no.
Did we get to watch this soon?
That was great.
All right, what's the deal with Subcore Records, and why are you producing in UK at the same time as in the
Subcore Records?
Yeah, look it on him.
I'm done.
Subcore Records is a dink. All he's interested in is his brother's band, the Dehumanizers, and he only, when he presses our record, he only presses 1,000.
And his
records get sold too fast. So then he went and he sold the rights over to Europe on COR. So now they print them up and sell them over here for $12. And he's too lame.
Yeah, I paid $9 for mine.
He's not even getting
yellow cover and
that.
He's not even getting money for it because they're ripping them off.
There was no contract with those.
So I heard you guys like made $60 total on the entire deal.
Maybe
$100.
Maybe four $30 checks.
Yeah.
I remember distinctly getting in four $30 checks and then splitting them up four ways.
We didn't split them up though.
Ran out of the house, golf course.
Except Chewy, our old bass player. He always wanted to make sure he got his just bought it.
We're making
yo, buddy, let's go get that.
We're
going
to go.
Here we go.
I mean, he died.
I haven't seen him. Martha got him.
And it went just like last August.
And it hasn't been long enough.
I saw it slur this
guy. Look, he's
looking at me again.
We kicked him out because it was a dick.
A dick.
She was a dick?
Chewy was a dick, so we kicked him out of the band.
And so now there's Alex.
There's the gold cap on the cavity.
Now we have a guy that can really play the bass guitar.
Yeah. Yeah, he saved us. A lot of people back home to us were really lucky.
I thought you were raping in action, isn't
it? I have yet to find out why we're really
lucky. Chewy was a dick?
Float.
Say hi, Shell.
It's really neat.
Hi.
it's really neat to have a guy in the band that can play his instrument as well.
As well as what?
As well as play himself. I don't know. Whatever.
Well, choreography. Jumped.
What do you have to say for yourself?
Flip it out. He lost
each.
It.
I looked at them both, punched me in both arms.
That became his mainstay. That's all he did.
Main punching bag.
What was Chewy's mainstay?
Did a few jumps, but the rest of the time he just stood back there. Mm-hmm.
And then he'd go, oh, God damn it, I gotta get over to the practice so I can go sell some coke and go fuck my girlfriend, because that's all that matters.
That's what it was. It was really sad.
I thought he hustled weed. And he weighed it really light.
Yeah, his address,
really light grams.
His address is Seattle Police Department. His address is okay.
He sold like grams.
No, it's like an RKL record. Like visit Dead Ted at scratch it out, right?
I'm being.
All right. I asked you, Tom. I know it is. Asked, what is your musical influence?
Mine in particular?
Yeah, as in guitar. Like, who's your guitar idol?
My
kid. Like, are we talking like back to Hendrix and shit like that, or like?
Maybe as back as far as Black Sabbath. You know, that's about as far back as I think music, my musical. Stuff like that. And then recently Metallica and Creator and Boy Bye.
Sacrilege.
Exorcist. Sacrilege.
Get that Metallica poster on that.
Sacrilege. This man caught the Sacrilege ripoff. Don't let anyone
Well,
know.
I saw him in Bankless, but that guitar is like...
Sounds exactly, doesn't it?
Well, not exactly, don't tell them. But just a little bit.
No, yeah, stuff like that I really dig.
Now ask Alex what his
musical
influence. Alex! Well, this will be fun.
Play the bass. I can't play the bass. I just can't.
Are you
I like the male tillets. I like all different kinds of music. I have such a diverse music taste, I can't go into it in depth at this point in time.
He likes Iron Maiden and Judas Priest.
I like Iron Maiden and Judas Priest.
Now he likes John Diamond.
Alright!
Yeah.
My slagging somebody's gonna see this in some hierarchy.
Who cares, man?
I don't care myself.
At the Slayer played entire theater and Wass is there. We walked out and Black is coming in. It's like, where's everyone going? Like, you suck, we're leaving.
Really?
Who was that? Kind of
standing on top of the fucking seats.
All right, I'll ask you last. And what is your musical influence?
You ever heard that song? Raindrops keep falling on my head. That's it. That's my musical influence. I have.
Just like guys.
That covers it. That's. Fuck, man. I don't listen to anything else.
When you start playing drums.
I don't even listen to us when we play. I just do it.
Really? When did you start playing drums,
man? I started playing drums
back in
1843. Yes, 1843. Me and my mom came across in a covered wagon.
With the banjo on their knees, right?
That's going to be so funny when you look at that. You're not sitting right here.
That's right.
Now to Blaine.
Do you want to know specific people that I would pattern myself after?
Well, since you're a vocalist.
I'd like to
what's
know
your,
that.
What's your, do you have any pair of vocal talents? Or?
Ron Reyes.
Who?
Ron Reyes, the first singer. Second singer for Black Flag.
Yeah.
Oh, definitely. Yeah.
Jealous again after Josh again?
Definitely.
Thank you.
Chopper Crash. And who, Darby?
Darby Crash.
Yeah. Yeah. And Cal, Discharge,
of course. Tell him what he's won, Giant.
He's won a box of Reese's cups.
You and my pattern are such.
Melt some of your butter and mouth.
But actually, Ron Reyes is the best.
Yeah, I think so. He blows Henry away, don't he? Oh, man.
Henry's lame.
He's,
that's what I think.
I like that.
lot of people like
it.
And Craig, how did you break your leg?
I was riding a bike with two flat tires at 3 o'clock, totally drunk in the morning, and got hit by a car.
How can you do that without moving your leg?
Because we know the story.
He didn't say anything. He's like, girl,
so what?
It's all Greek to me. I got an eye ache.
Unbelievable. First of all, your eyes.
She was poking his eyes out tonight.
That's why we do that.
All right, what other covers do you do?
Angry Samoa song, Lights Out.
Yeah, besides that, do you do any of
that? Our Way, that first song we played?
Devil Woman by Cliff Richard.
We do a blues song, acoustic blues song.
You guys did.
Craig was there.
I used to do Highway Star.
All right.
Breaking the Law.
Deep Purple then too, right?
Oh yeah, sure.
Yeah.
Right.
Rock guitars.
What about Bruce Springsteen?
I taught him everything he knows.
Bruce Springsteen has a question that comes
to mind. Yeah, we did first.
Really? What is that doing?
But what about King Diamond?
What about King Diamond?
What's he doing these days?
What about Rusty? It's like, I'm a zombie tonight.
Hit it, Rusty, hit it.
Rusty wishes he was a smoker in their body.
Did you find weed?
Green pot.
A little bit. Not much, a little bit. Go.
I've been thanking everybody that's ever smoked these guys out on this tour because it makes
it's
my
really green. We'll buy it.
You like a smoke puff. Someone sell them the pot.
Lots of Tom likes it so beer.
I like it when these guys are stoned.
Turn the camera quick. We don't want this shit.
What happens when you drink beer?
What happens when I drink beer?
No, tell me what happens when you eat prime rib. And then drink beer.
I puke for days. Weeks, months, eons. I drank 2 years ago. I'm still puking to this day.
So what do you
do? What?
You shit blood.
You shit blood. Don't you shit blood? Yep, I shit blood when I eat meat.
Are you a vegetarian?
I should have now. Sure.
What about animal rights? What do you think about animal rights?
What animal rights?
Yeah.
I don't know. What about animal rights? You gotta put right. That's from rights first. You know. This thing's looking at me.
It moves. It's like, oh, it's alive.
It's a zoom lens.
It's alive.
Yeah, do the, face and. Somebody, very quick.
Is that you and I? 2 days.
Okay, Blaine, back to you.
Yeah.
Favorite comedian?
That was at a party before.
Sam Kinison, Richard Pryor,
what?
Alex, the favorite comedian over here.
Actually, there's people that are less professional that are far funnier than anybody you'd ever see on TV.
Most definitely. And the funniest people don't realize that they're funny.
The funniest people are the people that are walking on the street.
Billy Hayes.
And remember,
see, they're not aware that they're funny.
Never trust anything that bleeds for a week and doesn't die.
That's right. They don't know.
You keep going.
One deep, you think he may already talk. Sorry, lady.
We had this.
It's
a
funny joke.
We had this man. We had this man dancing on stage with us in Columbus, Ohio. I guess he was 79 years old, and I don't know if he's crazy or whatever, but we had him up on stage with us, and he was dancing. Alex can show you.
Perfectly. He was the best.
Dance for
come on.
Dance for
Cowboy
John. Really quickly. He was going stuff like this.
He was going.
Tell him that was it.
And he was just going crazy, and he was sweating.
Then he go, Alex has got a great cookie joke.
And he's doing it,
and the thing you have to realize is he was almost 80 years old, and he was sweating as much as we were, and he didn't stop, and the tempo is incredibly fast, and he was right on the money every time, man. He was right there.
For the whole
it was phenomenal.
And then
he was as much a part of the band as we were.
And then when we played Columbus, Ohio the next week, we had this other team that we met, both at the same bar, and he came up and did Batman with us.
Which we have on video.
Which we have on videotape.
Batman.
And then in Seattle.
In Seattle!
Seattle, we got this guy that stands up on stage that's just like a Beastie Boy, you know, like this. And he's got the big thing there, you know. It says a gentleman on it. It's like a sign from the bathroom. He just stands up there. Sometimes I'll play air guitar. Sometimes I'll give him the mic and go, yeah! Yeah!
He's got real. All right. Dark,
he's got a big apple now.
Alex has got a great joke about
flat top. When we go back.
Alex has got a great joke about cookies.
What's a joke, Alex?
Okay, this guy goes into this bakery. It's this erotic. You probably heard this. They think it's funny. He goes into this erotic bakery, and he's looking around, and he sees in this bin pussy flavored cookies. And he's standing, and he goes, "Well, that's kind of weird. That's kind of hard taste to duplicate." So this is the guy. Pussy flavored cookies, how do you do that? Guy goes, "Oh, check one out." Guy picks it out and goes, "This smells like shit." Guy goes, "Turn it over."
You're watching me again.
Okay, these three pieces of string go into a
bar. No, no.
I hate that.
That's a long one.
We just heard that one the other day.
It's a good joke.
All right.
Never
you know, sometimes an aluminum can has a real thin spot in it.
I'd love it.
We know this guy named Scott. Profile.
I'm looking for it
right there. Look at that. Only some cans do it. About one in every.
He's got a big door thing on the middle of his skull.
Okay. What do you think about audience participation?
That's
the only reason we drink beer.
And so, like, when you guys say fucking for bucks, like, that everyone's saying, it's cool, right?
Yeah.
You know,
a lot of places we play, everybody sings.
Sometimes they do. You ever notice that?
It's great. That's like a real soft spot, right?
Yeah.
What do you think about the Philly crowd?
About the what?
The Philly crowd.
That's good, except for those skinhead guys.
You get a wrinkle in the aluminum.
Yeah.
And it's like real thin right there.
And that's lame because they're all.
From Jersey.
Here,
and Rusty to you.
You thought it was
going
to drink.
This is the only place we've had trouble with skinheads.
Really?
Big skinheads, they're huge.
Yeah, we play in Canada and Portland. They would have every place where there's supposed to be a problem.
Are you serious?
I'm like, love us,
I want to go, but their skinheads going thin on the way. I'm ready for them to walk in and they didn't know.
Look at that pig on TV.
I was
good
to go.
Ugly American.
What's mosh?
Ask SOD.
I have another name for oatmeal. Mosh.
SOD is one of the lamest concepts. Is
that with a...
In case,
no, they
in
broke
case
up
Jimmy
nuclear
ever
assault
it,
now.
Come on, really?
Yeah.
Is it the same thing?
It's like a New York thing. But they don't really skate. They do this, like, you know...
Yeah.
They get their eyes like this and shit.
They're lame.
Do you ever notice when they're about every 56 beer can, you get a real soft spot right there? Right there.
These guys are gay right here.
Right there, see?
You buy that really cheap beer.
And
like every fourth case, we're all lovers.
That's
what we're
talking
about.
Serious. See, we consider quarters.
That's my brother.
When we get to the campground, they want a quarter to take a shower. We just all get in there, soak each other down.
Verbal abuse.
So we just want to say one thing. We want to play for you, not against you. And this first song is off our first record, a record called Victim of Pain. The song is called. Thank you. for you old timers out there. Who? Anyway, let me just say something. Vinny Stigma, our guitarist, quit last week. And here's Johnny. For 1 week, he knows all the fucking songs. And he came all the way from Baton Rouge, Louisiana. So you guys, when you guys give him a hand, he's fucking great. And this is called Society Sucker. actually right now, he's playing on dust. Let's ask him if he saw Satan yet. Because he seems to see him all the time. Did you see Satan yet?
Make the music!
All right, guys, remember, there's no two. There's no justice. Just...
There's a way of life out there in Lumberjack City. We call it dream. concerned here, folks. I think somebody choked it up before. We'll have to fix that guitar up later, I guess. No, it ain't starting. It ain't starting. So I'll tell you that much right now.
You're embarrassing me.
Well, Dave. But you know what? Use this thing for us. It's fucking small. Use it like a shaker. There, start now. Here. Yeah.
back from Ardmore, PA. The one, the only.
Shit.